Winning at Horse Racing 2022, we continue on, and remember, the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results. And we're going to talk about how that applies to horse racing, again, as we start to develop ways to ultimately be alive in bigger tickets with longer priced horses at the end of pick fours, pick fives, maybe even superfectas, including that right long shot. We're taking a look at wagering strategies. In part one of the video, we did a look at ABC ticket construction. Part two, we took a look at caveman wagering. And today we're gonna take a look at the art of picking horses versus wagering, how to use horses, which horses not to use, how to get value out of those horses in bets like the Rainbow Pick Six with a very high takeout. But on mandatory payout days, there is a positive expectation. Also on some of the bigger racing days at Gulfstream Park, New York, Triple Crown events, Breeders' Cup, the pool size in those pick fours and pick fives does allow you to expand your bankroll, play deeper tickets, and get some of those longer priced horses, because it's one of the few days left on the year, the maybe 15 to 20 days where you do have a variety of pinions, a large amount of money, and that takeout can be absorbed through some of the losing wagers. Again, part three, we're going to talk about picking versus wagering. And this is probably the biggest misconception I see. In part one, we talked about ABC ticket construction. Part two, I talked about caveman. But, you know, I think in more recent years, people have kind of given up on handicapping, and the value of picking a winner is extremely important in multi-leg races. And when I say picking a winner, using the all button, using six, seven, eight horses in a 10 horse field, what people are doing there is they're going more for a survival type method. And that's what seems to be the proliferation, because people are seeing that with the different social media posts from wagering outlets, ADW Wagers, TVG, Brisnet, TwinSpires. They're trying to get you to bet more money. They're not coming out with strategies to optimize your tickets. They're doing those $70, $90, $100, $120 tickets. And people that show winning wagers from those large tickets, I think they're not quite talking about some of the different strategies and how they got there. So that's what we're going to do in this series, get you caught up on wagering strategies, picking a winner, and also then we're going to go into handicapping long shots. Then we're going to take a look at speed figures, get you set up to actually get involved in more of these deeper wagering pools on bigger days with a chance to be alive three or four races deep into it, with a chance to maybe either hedge out or at least get alive deeper on into the tickets. Now, remember, when you look at caveman tickets, that is the art of using every horse equally on all your tickets. Your 2-to-5 shot along with your 30-to-1 shot, they have equal coverage. And the difference when you're starting to look at those when you're handicapping versus wagering, you want to take a look at horses who can actually win the race. That's important when you're doing multi-leg wagers, pick doubles, pick threes, and pick fours, because sometimes there's horses when you handicap them out due to a pace scenario. Maybe another horse is going to show speed. Maybe there's not a lot of speed in the race, but this horse could lead to the turn. These horses might have better chances to win in vertical wagers, in trifectas and superfectas, but not in horizontal. So when you're picking winners and when you're setting up your grids for A, B, and maybe the X column, X horses are horses you don't like to win, but they might be horses that you may want to use at the bottom half of a trifecta or superfecta. Also, you want to have to weigh your opinion. So even though you like horses 1 and 2, which one do you like more? And you use the horse that you like more in your multi-race wagers or more times if you're playing multiple tickets. Again, even if you don't want to necessarily go full scale into your doing multiple tickets with deeper denominations, you can still use multiple tickets to play more horses and get alive at least for that 50 cent denomination. But you do have to rank your horses. So you'd play your top pick with your second and third choices for example, in a pick three, and then you would play your third pick with your top two choices in the next leg. So again, you'd still be using extra horses, you'd be spending more money, but ultimately it would be cheaper than a caveman ticket, and it'd be weighing your opinion if you want to press on some of those selections. And then you want to get a higher ROI. If you're betting $100 to get a $250 pick four, that's the same. You're probably doing a single in there, and you may be better off just putting that $100 to win on a 2-to-1 shot. So identifying who can win those races on the deeper end of the tickets can be a separator between better handicapping. Now, remember, on the mandatory payout days, they can offset the takeout and provide EV value. So and again, also use these in some of the smaller tracks that are offering low takeout. Canterbury, Retama, Mahoning Valley on their pick five. Of course, one of the things that I'm always a big believer in, and I'm seeing more and more of these tickets, again, from the ADW wagers, they're stressing the all button, and this will destroy the bankroll long term. There's a difference between using long shots that have a shot or that you think have some kind of handicapping angle versus all the horses in a race. So if it's a 9, 10, 11 horse race, when you're timesing that out by 3-4 races, and then you're doing that 2 or 3 days a week, all of those losing wagers are going to grind away at your bankroll. I see more and more longtime horse players that I've been talking to in recent years. They're losing more money than ever. For a lot of years, they were doing well and kind of holding their own, maybe only losing 5-10% on their wagers, betting a lot more money. Now that handle just churns quicker, and I firmly believe in the long run, that's why some of the handle has gone down on thoroughbred horse racing, because of the emphasis on pick fives. If there's a way to make money in an exacta or a trifecta or even a daily double, playing more than one or two pick fives in a day, that's a lot of handicapping. So you really have to identify. And what's happening in most recent years with horse racing is you're getting the favorites, you're getting the short fields, people are spreading and using that all button and not spending as much time on their ticket construction versus handicapping the races. So again, you handicap the races beforehand, even if you're doing it the day of. You're a weekend warrior, a lot of times you don't get to those races before the morning, and sometimes that's even beneficial because then you have the scratches, you have the post positions, you have the final odds, and you can start your handicapping the day of, but you have to account for the fact that those short fields and the lower prices, playing multiple pick fives in one day, it's just a long grind on your bankroll. And those caveman tickets that TVG and some of the other people are emphasizing, they can damage your bankroll as well. So now, handicapping versus betting, it's the art of using horses that you think have a chance to win or possibly be second, third, or fourth if you're doing vertical wagering, versus just throwing in the all button or taking 6 or 7 horses. Remember, in a chaos race where everybody is using a lot of horses, sometimes that's the race to use 1 or 2 horses because you can extract some value out of another race. In a race where everybody's singling a horse, that's where you take a 10-to-1 or a 20-to-1 on a smaller ticket, because that's going to be, even though he might be 10-to-1 in the win pool, he might be 20-to-1 in that pick four. That is where you're going to get that extra ticket value on those longer priced horses, especially on these big days when you have bigger pools and everybody's concentrating in on the same horses. My biggest takeaway on video number 3 is never bet the all button. That is not handicapping. It'll destroy your bankroll long term. It'll also eliminate some of your chances where you can go 2 or 3 deep in a race. Look for races where maybe you can go 1 or 2 deep. That is better than going 8 or 9, 10 deep in another race if you're handicapping it out. If you didn't have time to handicap all 5 races, find other ways to make that pay in a pick 3 or a double or an exacta, because at some tracks, even NYRA, your exacta takeout is a little bit less. Other race tracks, that superfecta, the takeout is just strong. Unless you get a 10-11 horse field or you toss that favor out of there, the value just is not there. So definitely think about picking winners, and do they have a chance to win, or do they have a chance to finish in the money? Remember, this is part of a 5 handicapping series. ABC ticket method is already up. Caveman ticket was part 2. Part 4 will be pick and strategies. Look for that. And then bankroll and ticket selection and size. What are optimal ways to improve your handicapping? Do you optimize your win wagering? Are you handicapping your tickets? Leave a comment below. What are some things that you'd like to learn more from a handicapping and ticket structuring standpoint? Smash that like button and hit that subscribe button, as we want you to be a winning horse player in 2022.